Hello everyone, please like my video and subscribe.
Pep Guardiola aims comments towards Premier League over Liverpool dominance. Manchester City manager Pep Guardiola took a bizarre sweep at Premier League chiefs over Liverpool dominance this season. City have set the benchmark for excellence in the competition over the previous two seasons, accumulating the highest 2 points totals in English top-flight history of 198, with the latter ensuring that Liverpool's total of 97 last term was not enough to wrestle their crown from them. However, with Jurgen Klopp's men currently unbeaten, having won 24 of their 25 Premier League fixtures in the current champion, they have built up the biggest gap on any league leader in the competition and left second-placed City some 22 points in their wake. Currently an incredible 47-point swing to when Guardiola's side finished 25 points above the Red 2 seasons ago. Back then, when City became the only top-flight side to go turn up with their points tail to date, clinching the title with some 5 games to spare. Premier League chief executive Richard Scudamore and Gerard Senior figures at the Etihad by appearing to suggest that their runaway triumph was not good for the competition. He said, "It doesn't take away from City's excellence, but we want the season to go to the last. I'd like multiple trophies needed in various locations on the last day because we don't know how it will end." Scudamore has since left his position, but with City's 6th defeat of the season, propelling Liverpool ever closer to the title and their own amazing consistency producing the prospect of it being clinched with a record number of the games to spare. Guardiola, who kept his side locked in the dressing room for 45 minutes after their loss, sarcastically questioned whether the competition's top brass might be worried by the red dominance. He said, "Two seasons ago there was the owner of Premier League who said that could not happen again. It's not good for the Premier League for City to win the title in that way, with 100 points. Now it's Liverpool. You have to be conquered if you are the owner of the Premier League." With Liverpool needing just 18 more points from the 39 available to them to secure the title, Guardiola admitted that there is nothing that his own team can now do to stop them and that City's targets have already been downgraded. He added, "They are unstoppable. They have a lot of points. We dropped points in the games that we played quite similar to today, even when we played Anfield. Now it's to try to qualify for the Champions League next season." Wolves have completed the £19 million signing of Portugal winger Daniel Podence on a 4-year deal from Olympiacos. Podence touched down in the Midlands on Wednesday for a medical and has now put pen to paper on a deal that will see him go straight into Wolves' squad for the game against Manchester United on Saturday. The 24-year-old can play on either wing and is just the latest Portuguese addition to a Wolves squad laced with impressive players from the country. Sheffield United are closing in on 2 new signings with Panagiotis Retros and Sander Berg, set to join the Premier League outfit from Bayer Leverkusen and Genk respectively, according to reports. It's fair to say few would have expected the Blades to be sitting just a point behind Manchester United with just 4 months remaining in their first top-flight campaign in over a decade. Chris Wilder's high-flying side have certainly made the mockery of the pre-season predictions, and one of Europe's most attracting footballing teams are now seemingly set to strengthen their ranks with 2 of the most promising young talents around. After the acquisition of Villar, Roma has now finalized the deal for Carlos Perez. The Giallorosso clubs made the blow statement about the transfer on their official site. The winger, 21, joined from Spanish side Barcelona on an initial loan deal for a fee of €1 million. The agreement also includes the obligation to make the transfer permanent, based on the achievement of certain sporting targets, for a fixed initial payment of €11 million. The deal also includes a number of additional performance-related clauses worth up to a maximum of €4 million in additional payments, if and when the deal is made permanent. Perez has signed a deal with the club that runs until June 2024. The former Barcelona players also shared his truths on the move. "I know I am leaving a great club like Barcelona, but I am joining another great club in Roma," Perez said. "I'm really happy and I can't wait to start training alongside my new teammates." Manchester United address Bruno Fernandes transfer saga and Alexis Sanchez future. Time is running out for Manchester United to add to their squad before the January transfer window closes on Friday night. Manchester United manager Ole Gunnar Solskjaer had no update to provide on Bruno Fernandes and claimed Alexis Sanchez would prove his critics wrong. The winter transfer window is open for just 3 more days and Fernandes, 25, start in Sporting Lisbon's 1-0 league win over Maritimo on Monday night at the José Alvalade Stadium, where his family and agent Rui Guimarães were in attendance. United balked at Sporting's 18 million euro valuations of Fernandes nearly 2 weeks ago and have made no headway in negotiations. Despite frenzied speculation over the last week, it's understood nothing has changed on United's pursuit of Fernandes, and club sources have highlighted Portuguese clubs' knack for using the country's media to try and put pressure on potential buying clubs to close a deal. The injury-prone Sanchez, 31, has played 214 minutes this season on loan at Inter Milan this term, but Solskjaer suggested he could return to the United fold for next season. The January window closes at 11 p.m. on Friday, but Solskjaer suggested a reporter had wasted a question by asking about Fernandes. "I haven't got any updates for you on transfer," Solskjaer said. "I think it was a waste. I gave you options. I haven't got anything to say now. My mind is just on the game against Manchester City." Arsenal's deals to sign Flamengo defender Pablo Mari has collapsed, sources have told ESPN Brazil. Mari, 26, arrived in London on Saturday to complete the transfer to the Emirates, but the defender is now set to stay at Flamengo. Sources have told ESPN Brazil that Flamengo were opposed to term of Arsenal proposal and Mari has already returned to Brazil after undergoing a medical in London. He was expected to become the club's first signing since Mikel Arteta took charge, but Arsenal will need to explore other options before the transfer window closes at the end of the month. Mari, who was on Manchester City's book from 2016-2019, enjoyed a stint at Deportivo La Coruña before moving to Brazil. Despite never playing a single match at the Etihad, Mari stayed to be close with Arteta. Mari has played for Flamengo since July 2019 and was instrumental in the Rubro Negro winning the domestic and Copa Libertadores crowns. Sources have also told ESPN Arsenal are likely to miss out on Paris Saint-Germain target Lewin Kurzawa, who is set to join Juventus in exchange for Matteo Desiglio. Manchester United are expected to sign Bruno Fernandes over the next few days, with the deal to be completed imminently. The Red Devils have been trying to wrap up the signing of the Sporting and Portugal midfielder Fernandes all month, but the saga has dragged on into the final week of the transfer window. It appears it won't be long before Bruno Fernandes is officially a Manchester United player. Last week it appeared the deal had collapsed over financial differences between the two clubs. But the latest reports from Portugal suggest the transfer is back on and very close to be completed. O Jogo on Monday say only the finer details need to be ironed out ahead of the transfer being signed off. With the move imminent and Fernandes himself already preparing to leave his homeland for England, Sporting were initially demanding an upfront payment of around £50 million. Through it appears they are now willing to compromise and will agree to United's offer, which is worth £46 million upfront and a further £13 million in advance. Fernandes has continued to appear for Sporting during the transfer saga, with each new fixture allegedly his last match for the Portuguese outfit. However, it seems he is finally set for his Real farewell appearance on Monday evening, with Sporting hosting Maritimo in the Primeira Liga. Sporting's next match is not until Sunday, so if Fernandes plays that game at Braga, he has missed out on the chance of leaving this transfer window and will have to see out of the season with his current club, before securing a move elsewhere in the summer. Carlos Tevez may incredibly return to Manchester United before the end of January as the club desperately seek for extra firepower up front. The Argentine spent 2 years with the Red Devils under Sir Alex Ferguson between 2007 and 2009. He then swapped allegiances by joining Manchester City and won a third Premier League title there. Tevez has enjoyed success